هو ما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله من قول أو فعل أو تقرير أو صفة. هذا المحدثين ما يثبت قول فعل تقرير صفة. قول means saying, فعل means action, تقرير means consenting to or agreeing to. يعني for example النبي المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said something, that's or he did something. Or some people, some Sahaba al-Kiram radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, they did something in front of him and he did not say anything, did not object. Taqreer. Or as the Muhsan Muhaddithin say, sifa. Or a character. Whether it's khalqiyya or khuluqiyya. To al-Nabi al-Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. A character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa even if it did not fit the saying, doing or agreeing to. وحدّة يقول هنا وذي من أقسام الحديث. So we have now الحديث and we have أقسام, we have divisions of the hadith. And every division, how did it come? وحدّة. الحد هو التعريف. يعني وحدّة means the definition of it. فيقال حد الشيء تعريفه وتوضيحه. توضيح and تعريف and بيان of this حد. نعم. Or if you want to say وعدّة, you can also say that. So now he is going through the divisions of hadith and everyone that came and what is the definition of every single one of those classifications of the hadith from the Prophet صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله. أولها يقول, then the manzuma goes, he says رحمه الله, قال رحمه الله تعالى أولها الصحيح وهو ما اتصل إسناده ولم يشذ أو يعل. أولها الصحيح وهو ما اتصل إسناده ولم يشذ أو يعل. The first kind of hadith is الصحيح. الصحيح. That's the first kind. And الصحيح, now he's defining الصحيح. وهو ما اتصل. So the first of them is the صحيح. And it is what has connected its chain and has displayed neither solitariness nor weakness. I don't like solitariness. So let's say, and weakness, I don't like it either. A shudud is irregularity more than being solitary. Maybe you can say solitary is irregular, it's not with the rest. But that's what you mean, shudud. Walam yashudud, it means it's irregular, it's not the habitual. It is not what everyone, the whole thing was going as the whole river was going. Something came off. So you can say solitary, but I want you to think about it as irregularity as well. It's not the habitual, it's not the regular thing. That's shudud. أو يعل, العلة is a disease rather than a weakness. Okay, you may say weakness also, but there's a problem with it. And we will talk about that. Inshallah. So first of all, let's see these first three conditions. He says, أولها الصحيح. الصحيح then has اتصال of the إسناد. ما اتصال. There is this continuous إسناد, uninterrupted chain of transmission. That's called اتصال. ما اتصال. إسناده. So the إسناد is متصل. That's number one. Number two condition, no شذوذ. There's no irregularity. No illa. Number three. Cannot have any disease or debilitating cause. Now. Yarwihi, let's go through the conditions of Sahih and then I'll try to explain some of it. Yarwihi, the narrator, every single narrator of the chain of transmission of this continuously transmitted and narrated hadith. يرويه عدل ضابط عن مثله معتمد في ضبطه ونقله. Then the one who's transmitter, now first we know what the hadith itself has to be. أولها الصحيح, there has to be اتصال in the إسناد. الإسناد متصل. There's no شذوذ. There is no illa. Huh? Now, the narrator of the hadith must also have condition. Number one, must be adil. Adil here, the benefit of translation, a virtuous and perceptive person narrates it from one like him, while being reliable in his perceptiveness and transmission. I also don't like the translation. Let me try to make it different. The one who is the narrator must be adil. Adil means just. Just. You can say virtuous, but virtuous could mean pious. And pious is not necessarily just in the sense of hadith. I don't know if you hear me. يعني أبو حاتم الرازي and others say صالح هذا أو عابد زاهد. No, that's, wait a minute. That's not عدل, that's not necessarily. That's actually debilitating form. تمريض. Sometimes. خير. يرويه عدل ضابط. ضابط means, instead of saying perceptive, I would like to say accurate. ضبط is accuracy in the transmission. So the narrator must be just narrator. And must be accurate. That narrator, these two conditions, notice. But there's three conditions, we'll see. يَرْوِيهِ عَدْلٌ بَابِطٌ عَنْ مِثْلِهِ The one who is transmitting must be adil, just, must be labit, which means accurate. And he is narrating that through another one who is also adil and babit. But not only that, مُعْتَمَدُ الضَّبْط Which means, how do you say مُعْتَمَد now? Reliable in his accuracy. Let me put it this way. Not accurate. The accuracy is reliable and verified. There's a difference between sort of saying he's accurate in his transmission, then I make an emphasis. Mu'tamad. He is reliable. His accuracy is reliable. Notice. So, thiqatun thiqa. If we want to use now the جرح عن تعديل terminologies. But anyway, يرويه عدل ضابط عن مثله, not only that. They have to be reliable in their accuracy, not only accurate. Accurate by itself? No. Reliable in the accuracy. معتمد في ضبطه, reliable in the accuracy, and reliable in the transmission. The accuracy and the transmission. So now we have عدل, we have ضبط, And we have مُعْتَمَد فِي الضَّبْط and مُعْتَمَد فِي النَّقْل. Okay. Let's spend some time here. Because it's not that we go, I know the brothers have told some of the students that we should try to go through it all. But I'd rather go through quality than quantity. I mean, we'd rather get something out of here than not, than just go through the terminology and becomes like, then something among these that we forget. الصحيح. All these conditions, and it would be nice for you to memorize it whichever way you like. Whether you want to memorize it in English, or again, among these things, this is among the things we learned when we were young. And you know, وَالْوَلُوَ الصَّحِيحُ وَهُوَ مَتَّصَلِ إِسْنَادُهُ وَلَمْ يَشُدَّهَ وَيُعَدَمُهِ عَدَمْ رَابِطٌ عَنْ مِثْلِهِ مُعْتَمَدًا بِضَبْطِهِ وَنَقْلِهِ وَالْحَسَنِ etc. نعم. معروف طرقا وغدا. وَالْحَسَنُ الْخَفِيفُ ضَبْطًا I'll change some of the, and I'll give you some suggestion to change some of the original text, not alteration of the original text, just other inputs, okay? And I'll tell you why. وَالْحَسَنُ instead of the حافظ رحمه الله والأول الإمام بالكون says وَالْحَسَنُ الْمَعْرُوفُ طُرْقًا وَغَدَتْ سَبِيْجَعْلُهُ لَكَ الصَّحِيحِ شَرَتْ It's better to say وَالْحَسَنُ الْخَفِيفُ ضَبْطًا لأن الحسن معروف طرقا يا that's sort of given لكن خفيف ضبطا وغدت رجاله لك we'll mostly get there inshallah الصحيح so we go to the صحيح and the conditions of الحديث الصحيح طبعا you all know الإمام النووي رحمه الله under the sketch now he mentioned that one should not attribute قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم unless the hadith is sahih or hasan. And then you'll see some يعني, sort of more strict fiqhi approach or hadithi approach to things. Like hadithin, يعني, almost are And on the understanding that if the hadith is sahih, you don't say qala Rasulullah. You say it's attributed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And it is also good to explain that it is